Δείτε όμως στην αποκλειστική συνέντευξη που παραχώρησε στον Sky η πρέσβυρα του Ισραήλ, η Ρίτ Μπεν Άμπα, μιλά για τα ενεργειακά σχέδια στο τρίγωνο Ελλάδας-Κύπρου-Ισραήλ και ειδικότερα τον EastMed, που θα είναι ο μεγαλύτερος αγωγός ενέργειας στον κόσμο και θα καταστήσει την περιοχή έναν ιδιαίτερα σημαντικό ενεργειακό κόμβο. Εξηγεί δε τους φόβους της για την περιοχή και τη Συριακή κρίση, ενώ απαντά πως η λύση των δύο κρατών είναι η μόνη βιώσιμη επιλογή για το Ισραήλ και την Παλαιστίνη 70 χρόνια μετά την ίδρυση του κράτους του Ισραήλ. Μιλά επίσης για το ενδιαφέρον Ισραηλινών επιχειρήσεων να επενδύσουν στη χώρα μας. Η συνέντευξη που θα παρακολουθήσετε έχει παραχωρηθεί αποκλειστικά στον Sky και τον Απόστολο Μαγκυριάδη.
So, Ms. Ambassador, thank you so much for hosting Sky here for this interview. Let me ask you, we've seen lately a meeting in Nicosia with the heads of state of Greece, Cyprus and Israel. We see a hub, an energy hub creation in that sense. When do you think we'll have some developments on various projects that are underway?
First and foremost, thank you for inviting me for this interview and very honored to be interviewed by Sky. Now, in relations to the trilateral, first and foremost, we should look at it as an opportunity for the three countries, not only to discuss energy, but to discuss many other topics that are of common interest. And apart from energy, we are discussing issues that are related to the environment condition in the Eastern Mediterranean, emergency situations, anti-terror, health, cooperation in innovation and technology. In relations to energy, the EastMed pipeline, we are talking actually about two major energy projects. One of them is the EastMed pipeline, which is a very ambitious project, never have been implemented globally. It's a project of around 2,200 kilometers of a pipeline, quite costly. Nevertheless, the company that is conducting the feasibility study on behalf of the European Commission showed that this is economically feasible and from the engineering point of view, feasible as well. So the target now is to, by the end of this year, 2018, the four ministers of energy, Israel, Cyprus, Greece and Italy, under the auspices of the European Commission, they have to reach a point where they sign an agreement, intergovernmental agreement, that the four countries are willing to push it forward. So this is where we are now. If the project takes place, and I hope it's not if and it's only when, the project will not be in operation before 2023.
Let me shift the discussion a little bit on the economy. We've seen Greece coming out of this huge crisis and hopefully we're experiencing some kind of recovery. Do you see an interest of Israeli companies investing in Greece, and what are the possible areas of investment?
There is a great interest, and not only interest, but actual investment in hotels, in property development. This is taking place already in the last 1 or 2 years. I believe that we can see a growing interest from Israeli investors to come here and be sort of shareholders or partners in Greek companies, private companies, that are doing well. They are doing even very well, but they can maybe have an opening to innovation and to new markets if we encourage Israeli investments into them. And this is my target now, to see if we can encourage these Israeli investors to come and invest here in Greek companies.
Finally, we've seen some very negative developments lately in Israel and very negative pictures. In lieu of what happened even last week, is the two-state solution still in place for Israel and Palestine?
It is feasible. From our point of view, my government's point of view, and also the Israeli public opinion, this is the only feasible solution. Most of Israelis still view the two-state solutions as the only solution to the Israeli-Palestinian conflict. And we should all aim into this direction. And we are all waiting, us and the Palestinians, for the new proposal coming from the American administration, or rather from President Trump, to bring peace between us and the Palestinians. This is due, definitely. We are now 51 years after the Six-Day War, 70 years after the establishment of the State of Israel. It's about time that we solve this crisis between the Israelis and the Palestinians. And the two-state solution is the only solution on the table.
Ms. Ambassador, thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.